Good evening. This is Steve Fletcher with the Trumpet for My People, April 4th, 2018. Now I want to talk a little bit tonight about April 3rd to April 4th and maybe even a little bit into April 5th. Now before we get into a few things that I want to share tonight, I want to remind everybody that the date in question that we are watching more than anything else, and the date that is guiding and helping us to understand where we are, is the 17th day of Nisan on the Hebrew calendar, using the Torah calendar, is the best assessment of the true date that we should be watching based on the new moon that was spotted on March 18th. Okay, so we are watching first and foremost, okay, this is Resurrection Day. This is the, you know, the year of Jubilee just ended. Now we're in our first section of, feast days. And then we have another cutoff coming on May 14th, which is the end of the 70 years. So, I mean, we are really cutting it down to the wire. And, you know, our watch days are coming to an end. I mean, there's just really not much more. There's not many more places this can go. And so, you know, basically my idea right now is I'm going to be watching every day until he comes. But right now we're watching April 3rd and 4th. We are into April 4th in Israel. We are on Nisan 17 right now. Okay, so this is our main guide, okay? This is our main guide. And then what we are watching are all the signs that are put out that show April 4th as a key day within their planning. April 4th being connected to March 22nd by 13 days. Through the change in the Julian calendar to the Gregorian calendar. And so we've got all these connections. And then earlier today, I was watching some things about April 5th. I started looking a little bit into April 5th. I found something very interesting. That was first contact day, about the rise of the Phoenix, the successful flight of the Phoenix, and first contact being made on April 5th. And then now I just saw this one here. Let me go to the photo of this. And I just saw this connection about Martin Luther King being brought in, the bust being brought in, his connection to April 4th, and Winston Churchill being taken out on April 5th. His resignation on April 5th. So there's a connection to April 4th and April 5th. It has to do with the Torah calendar and the 17th day. But will it be within this exact... Okay, we do not know. We do not know. And so right now I'm watching. We were watching April 3rd and then April 4th. And now I'm going to be taking a little bit of a look at April 5th in this conjunction. Okay, and I just think that we need to watch and be very careful to watch until the very end. Now I want to give a scriptural example of this, of what I'm saying and the danger of cutting out too soon on our watch time. Let me share a scripture with you. Okay, I'm in 1 Samuel 13, and I'd like to read this section of scripture from 1 Samuel 13, starting in verse 8. He waited 7 days, the time appointed by Samuel, but Samuel did not come to Gilgal, and the people were scattering from him. So Saul said, "Bring the burnt offering here to me and the peace offerings." And he offered the burnt offering. As soon as he had finished offering the burnt offering, behold, Samuel came. And Saul went out to meet him and greet him. Samuel said, "What have you done?" And Saul said, "When I saw that the people were scattering from me, and that you did not come within the days appointed, and that the Philistines had mustered at Michmash, I said, 'Now the Philistines will come down against me at Gilgal, and I have not sought the favor of the Lord.' So I forced myself and offered the burnt offering." And Samuel said to Saul, "You have done foolishly. You have not kept the command of the Lord your God with which he commanded you, for then the Lord would have established your kingdom over Israel forever. But now your kingdom shall not continue. The Lord has sought out a man after his own heart, and the Lord has commanded him to be prince over his people, because you have not kept what the Lord commanded you." And Samuel arose and went up from Gilgal. The rest of the people went up after Saul to meet the army. They went up from Gilgal to Gibeah of Benjamin. Okay, so we are watching right now Nisan 17. Okay, we are watching here. Okay, and there is a desperation in the camp. Okay, I mean, this is what is shown here in 1 Samuel, that the people were scattering from Saul, and they were doubting, and they didn't know what to think, and Samuel told Saul to wait until I arrive, and then we will offer up the offering. And it got late, and Saul did something that was not in his hands to do. Saul was not the high priest. It was not in his jurisdiction or authority to offer an offering in that way. And so he did foolishly. He acted foolishly. He got desperate. He acted on his desperate feelings and on the feeling of the people. And so right now we are at a time where we are waiting, and we need to wait, and we need to be patient until the very end. Okay, and so I'm watching right now Nisan 17, which is April 3rd and 4th, but I've also seen some things on April 5th. Now, I've just seen one other thing on April 5th, and I will continue to search for more things, but I want to talk to you about, you know, we talked about first contact, April 5th, first contact. That's something from a secular, show, Star Trek. First Contact, April 5th, and the Rise of the Phoenix. Then we have the Churchill bust being taken out, Winston Churchill resigning on April 5th. Churchill resigning on April 5th. Okay, and now I found something. Kurt Cobain suicide / murder, April 5th, 1994. And the message behind the death of Kurt Cobain is the message behind the name Nirvana and what Nirvana means. So let's take a look at Nirvana, because this is connected for some reason. The death of Kurt Cobain is connected to the date that they want to bring in Nirvana. They want to bring in Nirvana. And so Kurt Cobain is a sign. The death of Kurt Cobain, April 5th, Nirvana. Let's take a look at this. Nirvana. And you guys can search on your own if you want to find other sources and other meanings behind the word Nirvana. But let's take a look at this and see what this says. It says, Nirvana, Nibbana, Nibbana literally means blown out, as in an oil lamp. An oil lamp blown out. The term Nirvana is most commonly associated with Buddhism and represents its ultimate state of soteriological release and liberation from rebirths in samsara. In Indian religions, Nirvana is synonymous with moksha and mukti. All Indian religions assert it to be a state of perfect quietude, freedom, highest happiness, along with it being the liberation from samsara, the repeating cycle of birth, life, and death. So Nirvana is the entrance into the final state of life where there are no more rebirths. It's the end. It's the last life cycle. Nirvana. However, Buddhist and non-Buddhist traditions describe these terms for liberation differently. In the Buddhist context, Nirvana refers to the realization of non-self and emptiness, marking the end of rebirth by stilling the fires that keep the process of rebirth going. In Hindu philosophy, it is the union of, or the realization of the identity of Atman with Brahman, depending on the Hindu tradition. In Jainism, it is also a soteriological goal. It represents the release of a soul from karmic bondage and samsara. Okay. The word nirvana, states Stephen Collins, is from the verbal root blow in the form of past participle blown, prefixed with the verb meaning out. Hence, the original meaning of the word is blown out or extinguished. Sandy changes the spelling, the V of vana, causes nis to become near, and then the R of near be causes retroflexion of the following nisvana to nirvana. Okay, well, there's a lot of stuff we could read on about this. I don't understand hardly any of this, but I think we all can understand that nirvana means blown out, extinguished. Blown out, extinguished. It's the end of the life cycle, the end of rebirths. It's the liberation from samsara. Samsara is the repeating cycle of birth, life, and death. Okay? So we have a connection here to Kurt Cobain, which was not a suicide. Most people say that he was killed on April 5th. And this is the sign of Nirvana, that on April 5th, they want to bring in this state of liberation from samsara, the repeating cycle of birth, life, and death, which is bringing in the end of humanity. It's perfect quietude, freedom, highest happiness, along with it being the liberation from samsara, which is the repeating cycle of birth, life, and death. Blown out, extinguished, nirvana. Okay, I don't have much more to add to that right now. Remind everybody that we are in the year of Jubilee, just ended. We are in the year 5778. We are in the 70th year from the rebirth of Israel. We are watching the Hebrew calendar. This is our guide right here. And this shows us April 3rd and 4th. Now, if we go a little bit beyond this, we need to remember the story of Saul and Samuel. And Saul, who got desperate at the very last minute, sacrificed an offering that he was not meant to sacrifice, and Saul gave him his rebuke. What have you done? And Saul said, when I saw that the people were scattering from me, and that you did not come within the days appointed, and that the Philistines had mustered at Michmash, I said, now the Philistines will come down against me at Gilgal, and I have not sought the favor of the Lord. So I forced myself and offered the burnt offering. And Samuel said to Saul, you have done foolishly. You have not kept the command of the Lord your God with which he commanded you. For then the Lord would have established your kingdom over Israel forever. But now your kingdom shall not continue. The Lord has sought out a man after his own heart, and the Lord has commanded him to be prince over his people, because you have not kept what the Lord commanded you. And Samuel arose and went up from Gilgal. The rest of the people went up after Samuel to meet the army. They went up from Gilgal to Gibeah of Benjamin. Okay? So we have a biblical exhortation to be patient, to wait on the Lord. He will come in the perfect time. He's still within the time frame. He knows when he is supposed to come. He knows we are watching. He knows we are waiting. He is checking to see the hearts of the people. The Lord has sought out a man after his own heart. Okay, the Lord is watching. Let's be patient. Do not get desperate. Take your worries, concerns to the Lord. Don't complain to me because Jesus hasn't come yet. All I am doing is watching. All I'm doing is trying to understand, to see. And I'm trying to watch day by day, and I'm trying to show the signs without, I'm trying not to make an absolute declaration that today or tomorrow is the rapture. We are watching, okay? We want Jesus to come, and we are watching the Torah calendar, and we're watching all the signs that go with it. So, okay, guys, I pray you're blessed tonight. This is Steve Fletcher with the Trumpet for My People.